And we're very honored this morning to have in Jeff Piccola, former state legislator, and now the chairman of the Republican Party here in York County. And good morning, Jeff. How are you?
Great. How are you, Gary?
Well, it's good to have you on. I'm doing well this morning. Wanted to talk a little bit about what's going on here in Pennsylvania, and specifically in York County with regard to Senator Toomey. And, of course, he was one of seven Republicans who voted with all Democrats this past Saturday to convict former President Donald Trump of inciting the January 6th insurrection at the U.S. Capitol. The former president was acquitted because the vote fell short of the 67 votes needed for conviction. The GOP assembly in Pennsylvania reportedly was considering censoring Senator Toomey earlier this year after he said that President Trump committed, quote, impeachable offenses, unquote. The York County delegation, the York County group of which you are the head, has come out basically and talked about censure and had talked about censuring Senator Toomey. I wanted to get in this morning what censure is, and is it right to censure when a senator votes, you know, his or her conscience, as obviously Senator Toomey did in this case. He's not running for re-election in 2022. So your thoughts about that this morning, Jeff?
Well, first, basically, I think a censure vote is, somebody described it this way, it's like putting a letter of reprimand in somebody's personnel folder. It doesn't have any real practical
right.
effect, but it's a blot of some sort on your record. I can only speak for York County, and let me just say this. I'm not opposed to people taking unpopular positions on issues or other things that they have to do. I've had to do that myself over the years in my career. But when somebody's elected to
right.
represent people, you have a certain amount of what we call political capital or goodwill. And once you're elected, you work very hard to build up that capital and that goodwill by making personal appearances before your constituents, by introducing legislation that's favorable and pushing legislation favorable to your district, helping people with their problems with government. There's all kinds of ways to do that. And when you have to face an unpopular vote, you have something to bank on. Senator Toomey carried York County in 2010, his first election, by 67% of the vote. Shortly thereafter, he started supporting gun control legislation, which doesn't go over very well in York County, you can imagine. By 2016, when he's facing re-election, he did not endorse President Trump, a fellow candidate on the same ticket with him. His percentage mm-hmm. dropped to 61%, and he ran 4,000 votes behind President Trump in York County. I could make an argument that actually Trump helped Senator Toomey in York County politically.
Interesting.
For 4 years, he's been making snarky remarks about the president and his tweets and some of the things he didn't agree with, and very little in the way of visible support. Now, he supported the president, I think, 85% of the time, but most of those votes were no-brainers for Republicans. So by the time this year or last year rolled around, Senator Toomey didn't have a whole lot of political capital or goodwill, certainly among Republicans in York County. So when he the vote that we took on Saturday was not in response to the vote to convict. It was actually brought about by some of the other things I just mentioned, plus the fact that he did not support the Rand Paul motion to declare the impeachment unconstitutional, which it really was. And mm-hmm. and if we're after unity in this country, the way to proceed is not to start impeaching former presidents. That's just not the way to go. So there was a lot of frustration in the York County grassroots, and the frustration stems from a whole lot of things: the election, alleged fraud in the election, lack of support from some people in the legislature, lots of frustration. And I think this vote and the fact that it was brought up in the first instance was a reflection of the frustration that people have with some of the folks representing them at higher levels. And that's a simple fact. I can't speak for the rest of the state. I can't speak for the other counties.
Right.
But I know there was a great deal of frustration in the York County Republican committee, and that vote reflected it.
Yeah, I've gotten the impression, and we talk to Senator Toomey every month, and I've gotten the impression over the years that, you know, he has not been a big supporter of Donald Trump, and that's okay. You know, listen, I'm not a supporter of the president on a number of the things he says and the way he says them. I've been supporter generally on a lot of the policies that he has put out there. I've not been a supporter of the way he got in his own way, tripping over himself to take credit for them when those policies could have stood by themselves and had some value. But that's a whole other topic.
Let me just interrupt you there. You're not a party elected official. And you're a commentator. You're in the media. You can comment on what the president does, like it or don't like there are certain responsibilities that party elected officials have as party leaders. That's part of our job. We may not want to make that very public, but it's the people at the grassroots, these 150, 60 Republican committee people that worked diligently to elect and reelect Senator Toomey in two elections and gave him pretty big margins in York County. So, you have an obligation politics and government is a team sport. It's not an individual sport. And so you may not like, I've supported lots of public officials, Republican public officials who I thought were on the distasteful side, but I agreed with their policies. Yeah. And so, I bit my lip and supported them. And that's the job of somebody. If you disagree with them on policy, fine. I have no problem with that whatsoever.
Sure. Jeff Piccola, the chairman of the York County Republican Party. I was looking at a comment that was made by Dawn Kiefer the other day, who's a state rep from the 92nd Legislative District. And she said, regarding the censure for Pat Toomey, she said, the committee, quote, has reached the limits of its frustration, unquote, with Toomey. We're talking a little bit about, when you're on a team, Jeff, and I really like your characterization of that, you know, if you choose to be on a team, be it Democrat, Republican, or whatever, but those are the two main parties, obviously, that you got to play by the rules of the team a little bit. And so I guess you being a former representative on the state level and well-known on the state level for a long time, how do you balance your individual convictions with the rules of the team? I mean, that's got to be a hard thing to do a lot of times, but what was kind of your guiding rudder there along the way when you were doing that?
Yeah, it is difficult. You have certain principles that govern your general philosophy toward government. There's an interesting document that the Republican State Committee adopted in 1991 called Statement of Principles for the Republican Party. And in fact, I was chairman of the committee that drafted them. And you try to use that as your guiding principle, but it's sometimes very difficult to navigate because there's nuances to legislation and there's levels of whatever is being proposed that, when you reach a certain level, it just may be too much that you want to support. If it's below that level, you could possibly support it. So it's a tough thing. It's issue by issue, and you have to just be in constant touch with your constituents, and you have to be in constant touch with your conscience.
You know, I was talking about Pat Toomey before, and the fact he's been on our show, and I wasn't going to the fact that comparing he and I, but I was just going to say that, one of the things that I've noticed is he has been loath to support the president during this time. And, it was interesting. I think President Trump gave many Republicans kind of an interesting, a paradigm that you either supported him and you were loyal to him or you weren't. And for a lot of people, they found that to be very tough because you had to support him on a lot of things despite of the personality that many people found to be loathsome. I'm not the first to tell you that. You've heard that, I'm sure. On the other side, they said, hey, we like some of the policy recommendations that he has there. In fact, we may like a lot of them, may like all of them. And yet, he seemed to, for a lot of people, get in the way along the way. How do you hold someone to a standard at that point? I guess you're saying, watch the Democrats. The Democrats seem to march in lockstep no matter what's happening. Republicans have generally seemed to kind of let people go a little bit away from the tent now and then. I guess I'm asking you about that balance point again, coming back to that. How do you hold someone to that balance point and say, okay, listen, we may find that candidate, as you said at the beginning here, not the one we necessarily like, but we still got to support them because we are on a team. And I thought that point you made in the first segment was really important, being on a team.
Right. Well, and you look back over the course of the last 4 years, President Trump never had a honeymoon. He was under fire from even before he was inaugurated. I mean, they were investigating
Russia.
They were calling him corrupt. They were filing lawsuits. I mean, they were obstructing his appointments. I mean, there's never been a president that has been so obstructed. And the gentleman had no experience in politics before becoming president.
Right.
Some people think refreshing. Others think, oh, we've got to have more experience. But the fact of the matter was a lot of people felt that was an attractive factor. And his method of operation, whether you like it or not, is if you lash out at him, he's going to lash back. And
that's true.
You know, I wasn't always comfortable with that, I will confess. But after a while, you thought, well, geez, the man deserves a break here. Get off his back about Russia. Get off his back about the Ukraine. Stop making this stuff up. All this stuff has been proved to be totally fallacious and made up of, out of whole cloth. And it wasn't just the Democrats. The news media was in on it as well. So you can understand, I can understand, I don't know about anybody else, but I can understand the frustration that he had trying to do what was right. I mean, his policies, in my opinion, were outstanding. He enacted into law and into policy more of the Republican principles than any president in my lifetime. I mean, when you stop and go back, it's amazing. And he has really kind of transformed the party from the party of the country club to the party of the working man and woman particularly because of his trade policies, but also because the prison reform legislation, which was very unfair to African American citizens. So he's never gotten a fair shake, and I can understand his frustration. And while I wouldn't probably have reacted the way he did, I can forgive it. And I think most of his supporters forgive it.
Yeah. Jeff, I really appreciate your time this morning. Unfortunately, we're out of time, but always good talking to you, my friend. Thank you so much for taking time to stop by and explain. I thought you made some really great points this morning. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Anytime, Gary. I got a wealth of knowledge.